Hi, so there's just a couple of things left. Firstly, I'm going to invite up Shusha, just to, our host, just to thank you. We'll have some information about No Time to Wait next year. At the end of that, we'll come up to the front for a goodbye photo, like all of us will be here. And then we will invite you over to a reception for the birthday of Matroska. We have cake and wine. But first, Shusha, would you join?
So I would like to thank you, the organizing committee, so that this year the Open Society Archives was selected as the venue for No Time to Wait. It's much more to the Open Society Archives just giving the space to you. I think the No Time to Wait is very much, or the spirit is so much part of our identity, not just you brought us a new workflow or with the help of No Time to Wait, we totally reformized our workflows. But it's really what was just said at this round table, square table, was what we identify with. So I very much hope that through this conference, we will be able to better reach out to people that we think we can learn from, or we can learn from each other. So thank you for coming. It was a privilege to having you here this year.
Hi, yes. So first thing first, let's see what's happening. Is this the moment? Okay, just real quick, voila. Welcome on stage, Johan Omen, head of research at Sound and Vision, our next host for No Time to Wait 5 2020.
Okay, so this is the announcement. It's going to be super difficult. I think it's impossible to, you know, organize a conference better than this year's event, but we will make a brave attempt. So maybe, you know, we can learn from our local host how to run an event as successfully as this one. So next year's event is going to be held in the Netherlands at Sound & Vision. These are the dates. It will happen in September, so it's only 292 days away. So we have to work super hard and to present new works to the community in just a couple of months, if you think about it. So Sound & Vision, it is the audiovisual archive and media museum of the Netherlands. We are located in Hilversum, and this is where quite a few media industry is concentrated: public broadcasters, commercial broadcasters, production companies, etc. It's half an hour by train from Amsterdam, direct train, 45 minutes, also direct train from Schiphol Airport. And if you would like to see Vermeer's painting, then you can go to The Hague, take a train, 90 minutes. So it's very easily to reach. Some pictures of what Sound & Vision looks like from the inside. The main picture, you see a couple of familiar faces. This was taken a couple of weeks ago when we hosted the YASA and JTS conferences back to back, which we are still recovering from. But it was awesome. Some words about Sound & Vision and using open source technology. We've been one of the partners in Performa. Performa played quite a big role in standardization of FFV1, as you know. Also, every year we host the Winter School for Audiovisual Archiving, and we make a brave effort to share the knowledge and the presentations and on the web. Many of those presentations also touch upon open source technology. I think similar to BFI, we hope that hosting No Time to Wait will have a positive effect on Sound & Vision, because I have to admit that we use proprietary technology for many of our workflows. So we also hope that by inviting the community, we can also make a difference there. So, two slides more. These are your local organizers: Erwin Verbruggen, Raza Bocite, myself. With this, I will hope to see you next year in the Netherlands. Thank you very much.
Yay, thank you so much. Also, if you have any interest in the future of hosting, please come and see us about it. Like, yeah, 2021, 22. All right, now, if we can all, in somewhat orderly fashion, try to move up front for the group picture.